Hello and welcome to Cosplayers React to Miraculous Ladybug. This week we are watching The Pharaoh, which is an episode from season one. I'm Hilda Glitz, I play Chloe in the 86th Floor cosplay music videos.
I'm Lou Manara, I play Marinette and Ladybug.
And I'm Raska Rabbit and I play Adrian and Kat Noir.
Alright, let's get started. Let's do it.
It's a 10th grade history book, and I should know because I've got this very same book. Could our very own Ladybug be a high school student?
Okay, I mean, that is a sensational angle. But something I will say, I know obviously that Alia's whole thing is that she wants to uncover Ladybug's identity, but like, does she not stop to think that this actually could be very dangerous for whoever is Ladybug?
Especially where she's going,
oh, she's a high schooler. Time to expose her on the world wide web.
Yeah, it's like, you'd think that Ladybug would, Marinette is Ladybug, right? But like, you'd think that Ladybug would be like, hey, I appreciate that you're a fan, but can you not like keep trying to find out who I am? Because like,
this mask I'll
have to give up my Kwame, and then I can't actually defend Paris, and then like, you would just get taken over by Akumas. Like, I feel like if she just communicated that to her, she'd kind of back off.
What's done is done. We can't change what happened. We can only move forward. Alia must not find out who you are.
Tiki's got her legs crossed.
That's so cute.
Her legs are like almost too small to cross as well, which is just like, I love that.
Tiki looks so cute in this.
That's so cute.
I love whenever she moves her eyebrows, the dot on her head kind of becomes like a heart shape.
Everyone has a past they can learn from. This'll show you why.
Tiki surfing da web. Tiki on Google Chrome, what will she do?
Gotcha.
I don't know, IDK, she do be browsing though.
Do you reckon like Tiki and Plag use the internet just...
Well, clearly Tiki knows enough. Well, maybe. Maybe they AOL Messenger each other.
Can you believe it? All I gotta do is find out who this history book belongs to, and bam!
And Marinette's anxiety must be going through the roof right now.
Marinette's sat there like
sweating, just like.
Also, is there a reason Tiki's being so like cryptic about this?
Honestly, like,
is she not allowed to tell her up front about the old miraculous users, or is she just being dramatic?
I think she's being dramatic because definitely later in the seasons, Marinette does actually get taught quite a lot about like the old miraculous users. So it's just Tiki being dramatic.
Yeah.
Oh, that is so cute. Tiki just being like, eh. So cute.
Hang on.
So I know they're going to go back to the museum in a bit because obviously the episode is called The Pharaoh, but I absolutely love the episodes of this show where they go a bit historical and you get to learn a bit about like the context of the miraculouses and who was before Ladybug.
Also, the Egyptian exhibit at the Louvre is obviously the best one. Like, it's so good.
It's very good.
Our very own Ladybug be a high school student in real life?
That's crazy.
Adrian, three screens aggressed. And also, I like...
You at the offices.
Yeah, except that... Right, okay. Yeah, it is me. And I currently do have two monitors at my desk. But I...
Not three.
I did used to have three. I used to be three screens. But the point of having three screens is so that you can have different things on each screen, not just three of the same thing.
He just wants all of his Ladybug pictures to be multiplied.
Yeah, it's
like,
true.
It's like in stereo. It's like a 3D experience. I just feel like that's Gabriel and Emily, I guess, overcompensating for neglect. Like, they don't just get him a fancy computer. They get three monitors, three screens.
Why bother yourself with ladies when you could be enjoying this? For one, ladies smell about 1,000 times better than that cheese, and they're much better looking.
That makes me giggle quite a lot because Adrian's been like, girls smell great. They're just awesome. Adrian do be respecting his women.
He do. Also, I love that he's giving Plag the consideration to like make that into a conversation. Because Flag is just like, mate, whatever, man. Like, women, don't even worry about them. Just eat cheese. And
just have some cheese.
Here's a step-by-step deconstruction of your argument.
And their opposite is Nefertiti, his princess. There are exactly 100 mummies beside them. She died several years before him, and the sun god.
Why is Alex's brother telling this to Alex's dad, aka his dad, aka probably someone who already knows this?
It's just the way he goes, yes, I know all that.
Speaking of dads, so actually it's funny watching this episode again because Alex's dad, a lot of people thought might be Hawk Moth, like before we knew it was Gabriel, even though Gabriel of course is the obvious choice.
Yeah, I mean, like, I didn't like vibe with that theory at all because like they just have different faces, you know, and like he has a mustache and Hawk Moth does not have a mustache.
Yeah, but Hawk Moth is also wearing a balaclava that covers his facial hair.
I mean, he's not wearing one.
It's not like there, though, down right? there, though.
Yeah, but then when you think of, like...
you get some cuffs sticking out.
Rena Rouge, for example. When Rena Rouge transforms, that significantly changes her hair. So I don't think... I wouldn't put it past a Miraculous to get rid of slash add facial hair.
Ad-Ra took her as his goddess.
Yes, I know all that.
Oh, yes, I know all that. Thank you.
For the hieroglyphics, but I have... It's a magic chant that needs to be recited in order to complete the ritual. I'm sure of it.
He kind of reminds me...
That's like the start of every horror movie ever, where they're like, there's an old ritual in a different language and no one's ever said it out loud before, but I will now. Don't worry about it.
Like, let's just do a chant. What could go wrong?
Do not do that.
Don't do that. If you find some Latin or hieroglyphic words and you translate them and it turns out to be a chant, please do not read them out loud. 2020 is bad enough.
It's bad enough, mate. We don't need any.
Don't need any sacrifices.
Don't even think of touching that scepter. I'd lose my job on the spot. It's a priceless historical object.
If this is lose your job worthy and you're the director of this exhibition, here's an idea. Maybe put it in a protective case. I don't know. Yeah.
He was like, if anyone touches this, I will lose my job immediately.
That's why it's on
a low podium in a non like guarded part of the exhibition with no glass or rope around it.
Yeah, it's not a good idea. You've got too much faith in the public.
Listen, Jaleel, that's enough. Get your head out of those papyrus scrolls and focus on the real world. This one.
That's really funny to me. Get your head out of those papyrus scrolls.
Also,
kids and their papyruses these days.
I love that, and focus on the real world. And it's like, I mean, ancient Egypt did happen.
Yeah, it's not fake. It's fake. Conspiracy theory: ancient Egypt was a hoax.
Especially when I can make it a week.
be like, there is nothing wrong with living out a fantasy. All right, it's what I do
you
every single
valid.
Day of my life. My wife will come back, and I will be happy.
Marinette is struggling here.
Wouldn't you be?
Yeah.
God, put that down!
How has Alia not opened the book and found out it's Marinette's yet? Like, because if the implication is that as soon as she opens it, she'll see Marinette's name written in it? Or have I missed something?
I feel like she probably would have looked to see that first.
Yeah.
Maybe Alia just knows, and she's just messing with Marinette. You'll mind if I sit down here and let myself get akumatized?
Tut, give me time!
So, the design of this guy is that he's like... The body stays the same, but his head can change through all the different ancient Egyptian god heads. Which is such a sick idea. I love
it. Yeah.
That is like, cool.
And it's like... Instead of just getting the power of one god, you get them all. It doesn't really have anything to do with Tutankhamun, but, you know, you can't have everything.
Yeah, it's really. Just roughly ancient Egyptian theme.
The vibes are there, therefore, it's all good.
You gotta transform!
Again, this hiding place, it's barely behind anything.
I feel like this is too easy to make fun of now.
Yeah, like, you're right. It's a low blow.
It's objectively, it's better than the park bench, but also is it because at least in a park, you're not under like surveillance. But like in a museum, you literally have CCTV. Like, yeah. CCTV knows now. good job.
Also in the park, like, there's a bunch of other stuff going on, like, no one's really gonna, you know.
But Tiki takes Marinette to the museum so she can throw Alia off the scent, and then she goes and does this.
Disaster.
Good job.
Bug viewers, I'm at the scene even before Ladybug or Cat Noir.
Now listen, if that was in a case, wouldn't happen, would it?
I love how Adrian is just constantly watching the lady vlog.
You're right! He's just like, sitting there watching the live feed!
She stopped recording hours ago.
He's been watching reruns and arguing with Flag.
I love the face changes. You could use that one.
Time to transform.
Is it just me or is that like a really, really low voice?
Savage.
Time to transform.
That is... Oh, no, I thought you were talking about... like the low blow that was.
Oh, that was a low blow as well. Yeah.
Savage. Adrian's got a beautiful face.
He's got a lovely face.
You know what needs to change, Flag? Your attitude.
Your attitude.
Your face. Fate has placed you on my path. Come with me.
Okay. I did remember that this was the plot of this episode, but it still like squicks me out. That he's decided that Alia is like his teenage bride. It's really grim.
It's a bit odd.
It's a bit cursed.
She says, hands off the threads. Like, she's worried about it.
Honestly.
And like, you know, I can respect that.
Hiding behind an innocent bystander? You're weak, Pharaoh.
I'm way more powerful than you are.
You're weak.
They could just run through those bars. Like, the bars are not that wide. Like, they're not that small. Like, they could just be like...
I hate this about cartoons and stuff because, like, it's so frustrating to the audience because they could just squeeze through them, but obviously they can't draw them too close together because then you can't see the characters, but it's just
You gotta suspend your imagination a little bit.
And don't forget, all the latest behind the scenes are on my blog!
That all you?
Alia, in the middle of being kidnapped, still remembering to do her calls to action, reminding people to subscribe, which reminds me, if you're watching this and you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell so that you don't miss any notifications. That was mostly a bit, but also if you're not subscribed, why not? Subscribe to our channel for more Ladybug content such as this. Ding!
There's one brave chick.
If by brave you mean bossy, feisty, and bold, yep, that's her. Come on, get us out of here, Cat Noir.
I like that Cat Noir, like, doesn't know that Ladybug is friends with Alia, like, set, like, in her real life. So basically, like, Ladybug's just been like, yeah, she's really bossy, she's really feisty. Who is this
like,
woman?
Hey, hold on. Like,
yeah,
she's
just like, whoa, okay. She's just, you know.
Alia's being carried out to her death, and yet instead of being saved, she's just getting roasted. Well,
she's like, she's just down the hallway. She's like, guys, I can literally hear you. That's a bit savage. Like, I feel like Adrian, you know, as Cat Noir, he's hearing this description of Alia, and he's like, oh, yeah, that checks out. That's exactly what she's like. And then he wouldn't think, like, oh, she knows her.
Yeah.
Like, he just wouldn't think that.
He doesn't think.
I feel like there's, like, layer of thought, and then you kind of can think a little bit deeper about things. It's probably like, you know, a little numbered system. He's number one always.
He doesn't even scratch the surface.
Just a surface thought. No thoughts appear.
No thoughts. Brain empty.
Don't think.
I've seen a few TikTok comments that are like, oh my god, like, why was Cat Noir my childhood crush? Like, Cat Noir really hit different. And I'm like, Miraculous came out a week ago.
No, it didn't. It came out five years ago,
yes,
mate.
Yes, it did.
Years ago.
Nah, I'm pretty sure it was just a week ago.
Yeah, people saying that their childhood crush is Cat Noir makes me feel so old.
just say your childhood crush was Ralph from Horrid Town, like everyone else.
Go ahead. I'll join you as soon as my Miraculous is charged up again.
Hurry up. It's gonna take both of us to defeat him.
Oh, that was a really cute moment where she just puts her hand on his arm and she's like, don't worry, mate. I've missed moments like that where they're just like, they're just, you know, they're there for each other, you know? This is kind of horrifying, I'm not gonna lie.
I'm also stressed out about that mummy that dropped his camera on the floor.
Yeah, that's stressed out. That's stressful.
This is the power allocation for Akuma's is so unfair. Like with the baby one, right? That was just a giant baby. He just made the baby really big and was like, you know what, I'll call it a day. Here, he has unlimited access to every single power of every single ancient Egyptian god.
Yeah, you're right. Like, it seems a little OP.
I kind of like that though, because it really, I feel like it speaks to how Hawkmoth's feeling on the day. Like sometimes you're just not feeling it, are you?
Like, yeah, that's true. Sometimes you go all out and you like, you know, you go in all guns blazing. But this is
akumatizing the baby was quite a bad day for Hawkmoth.
Yeah, that was
sometimes
that was
just, off you know.
Gotcha. You're talking about the spell on the papyrus, right?
Correct. The 100 mummies and the offering.
He's quite good at this interview, isn't he? Like, he's got his answers ready.
He's quite calm. Like,
very calm.
I love, there's something so mundane about asking a villain, like, what their plan is. And instead of being, like, the big elaborate, like, bragging speech, it's just like, all right, yeah, this is what I'm after. This is what's happening. These are the people that I'm gonna kill to sacrifice to get my wife back. Got any other questions?
You can tweet me at Pharaoh.
But I've already found her. You look so much like her.
Say what?
How has Alia only just noticed, like, she's only just clocked that what's going on here. Like, he hasn't just kidnapped her for a laugh.
Scoop. God, let her live.
Like, she's the starring role.
She literally asked him what was going on and he told her and she's like, wait, what?
Wait, what? She wasn't listening.
What?
I can relate.
She's a bad interviewer. She asks questions, but she's
she doesn't listen.
In the answer. You don't listen.
I've got to get out of
this. Sorry, what? I forgot about the bit where Lady was just like, I've got to get out of here.
I love Alia's message, like, hey, Ladybug, I just found out I'm the sacrificial offering to the sun god. Can you give me
please
a,
respond.
Give me a bell when you're around. I could use a hand. It's just, there's something very calm about the whole situation. It's very funny.
Ladybug, my sworn enemy. My nemesis may have kept me from carrying.
I love this little bit of lore. He's just like, ah, yes, Ladybug, my sworn enemy. Yeah. You didn't want to mention that earlier when you were fighting modern Ladybug? Well, like, it would have been really cool if you just turned around and gone, Ladybug, my mortal enemy from the past.
Everyone does have a past they can learn from.
Well, you don't look a day over 3,000.
Now you.
Something interesting I'm noticing about watching season one again, and I don't know whether this is. I haven't done any research on this. This is just me speculating. But I'm noticing that the English words don't match to their mouths, which, because this was first aired in French or Korean, I can't remember which one. But in later seasons, the English does match their mouth.
I know what this is.
You know what this is? Tell me.
It's because the first season was animated with different voices. You can see a clip or two on YouTube. They were fully voice acted and, like, it was just stunt voices to animate too. I guess they were trying to match the inflections of the original one, but it wasn't quite the same. So, like, that's why it sounds a bit out of sync, like in season one, because they're dubbing over some other people. And then obviously because they'd been cast properly in season one, they just recorded first and they animated based on that in season
one. But the animating was done to English dialogue.
It was done to English dialogue, but then it wasn't like their voices.
Okay. That's interesting. Interesting. So they sort of had
a
draft version of the voiceovers and then they got them to re-record. That's really interesting.
It used to really bother me as well, actually, in season one, but then, like, they fixed it in season two and three.
These are my brain cells when I'm trying to get out of bed in the morning, where they're like, awaken, awaken.
I like how Alia really do be crowd surfing.
I just love the lack of enthusiasm. It's so good.
Yes, King, give us nothing. That was some sick acrobatics from Cat Noir there.
I know.
Absolutely sick.
And he runs like a cat.
I love him.
It's cute.
Horus, give me your wings.
Ha 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 ha! I just love the way he, like, torpedoed off into the sky yeah. there.
Sick magic.
Honestly, this is thrilling. I'm gripped by this action sequence.
The mood.
This is
how good it is.
This is the stuff that made me fall in love with the show. Yeah. It's like it's
good choreographed action.
It's great. I don't like that the mummies just have their toes hanging out.
I don't like that either. Also, what ancient deity has the power to do sonic booms? Which one was that?
Sonic.
Sonic.
He's an ancient deity,
my
right?
My favourite ancient god is Sonic.
I guess the only way to explain anything to do with Sonic
the
is
hedge
the
god.
Sonic the Hedge God!
Damn, you're so right.
Whoa.
The Hedge God.
A ladybug outfit?
That's our last hope.
This pose.
That's last hope?
Those shoes with that
nano.
Skirt. Is he, you know?
Sorry, Cat Noir.
Does Cat Noir cuff his jeans?
Does he though?
Set Alia free and sacrifice me instead. Wouldn't that be the sweetest revenge? 5,000 years later.
She's got a point. That would be a pretty savage sacrifice.
I love Alia being furious, like, that she's not a good enough sacrifice.
I relate to that.
I'd make a great sacrifice. Not that I want to find out.
I don't
want to
be a sacrifice, but I would make a great sacrifice.
Yeah, I'd be great. I don't know. I'd feel a bit shattered by that, to be fair.
Go get it!
Get it! A toy?
That was a brilliant plan, but also what I find really funny about that is that had the energy of, like, you know, when you, like, fake throw a ball for a dog and then the dog, like, runs away and then it, like, looks back with his look of utter betrayal.
That's
like
a trick. Well, I find it interesting that he says get it because he wasn't addressing any of the mummies. The mummies aren't there, so was he just, like, turning himself to go and get
he's desperate. He's having a meltdown.
How old are you really? Much older than a high school student, that's for sure.
Sounds like something a high school student would say,
Marinette. Also, I like this. I like that if people believe this clip of Ladybug saying, I'm definitely not a high school student, this would explain, like, a lot of the, like, slightly dodgy crushes that adults around Paris have on her. If they're like, oh, well, it's fine. She's not a high school student.
That's true, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
You're right.
Don't lie about your age. Don't do it.
I got mummified. Hope you weren't one of the ones trying to swap me for Nefertiti. Creepy. What? You were almost sacrificed?
I know that we're obviously, like, revisiting season one by watching this, but, like, Marinette seems like this is a really good cover story. Like,
yeah.
Where's this cover story in like, you know, say, Puppeteer 2, for example, when
yeah.
she seems to have forgotten how to be a human being, like talk to other people. Whereas this is well thought out. She, you know, our alibi checks out because, you know, everyone was turned into mummies. She's act surprised that, you know, Ali was sacrificed. It holds up. Well done, Marinette. Where did your brain cells go?
Even Adrian could, like, chuck this one together, though. Like, when he was like, I got sent into a night, man. What a nightmare.
What a nightmare!
Bye.
Hey, Ladybug textbook, it's gone!
You might have.
Marinette, like, yeah, it is gone. Wonder who did that.
But where is it?
That's a good question.
Did she fold it in half?
Yes.
It in her
bag? Tiki's eaten it.
I like the idea that she kind of just left it behind, like, behind a statue, and that now
and she's gonna have to
go back
and
Louvre and then retrieve it.
Do you think she
went? What a palaver.
She left it in the Louvre. It gets put in lost property, and she has to go and reclaim it anyway.
I know I'm not 5,000 years old, so. Who exactly was that ladybug in the papyrus?
Okay, I love Marinette's little, like, her bedroom setup. Same. Like, with the little bookshelf. It's so
favorite.
Cozy.
That really, like, for me, for the longest time, I've always loved the idea of that, like, cozy little, like, bunk bed sort of space. And, like, I kind of have that now, but, like, it just, like, as soon as I saw her room, I don't know where I first saw it, what episode it was, but as soon as I saw it, I lost my damn mind.
It's like, so it's cute.
It's got the fairy lights. It's got all, like, the little comfort items, the big cat pillow thingy. It's got the little moon and stars light. And it's so cozy. She's got a little view of the outside. And I just, like, I want that so bad.
It's so nice. Her room is gorgeous. And it's got the balcony upstairs. Like, yeah. So good.
I'm not sure how Tutankhamun's fitted into all this, to be fair with you. Like, it's a bit confusing. Because, like, now they're talking about 5,000 years ago, right? Which was, like, the sort of the beginning of ancient Egypt. Like, was this papyrus old to Tutankhamun? Was that guy Tutankhamun, or was it just, like, some random pharaoh?
I honestly don't know. I don't think. I think it's just a mashup.
Didn't die until, like, a 1,000 BC. I just feel like it's quite a significant jump, and it's like, not to drag you for historical inaccuracy, but a quick Google could have sorted that out for you.
You don't look 5,000 years old.
I'm older than that. I'm a Kwame who has watched over every single ladybug since the very beginning.
I'm ancient, Marinette. I'm literally older than the sun.
So, the Big Bang, right?
That was TJ. No, that was Plag. That was Plag.
Plag created and Plag can is destroy the universe. Well, like
Plag. No, the Big Bang was Plag and Tiki together.
Yes. Oh my God. Yeah. Well, surely Ladybug is the power of creation, and then the Black Cat is the power of destruction, right? So presumably Tiki created the universe, and Plag will at some point destroy it.
Nice. Nice one, Plag.
Marinette, you are different, but different as in surprising, unpredictable, and endearing.
This scene is so cute. I love her kind of like IKEA lamp behind her. With that little
honestly,
very cute.
That's like, part of what I love Tiki's, about it, though. I feel like I had one of those.
She's so soft and gentle. And
oh, Tiki is such a good mentor.
I love how Marinette's like, you never had a ladybug as klutzy as me, right? And Tiki's like, every ladybug is different. It's like, way to dodge the question, you shady lady.
You better get to sleep. Remember, you have that history test tomorrow.
Oh yeah, good thing it's on ancient Egypt.
That was a very unique ending, actually. It didn't just cut to the usual kind of splash screen. It was like, a little different.
I just saw, like, imagine having a little Kwame and just like, hold.
Is held.
His head.
That was really cute. I really enjoyed that episode.
It was definitely one of my favourites. Like, I remember thinking that was amazing because I really love ancient history and, like, the Louvre and, I don't know, like, the museum is such a cool setting to fight crime in.
Yeah.
It really is, isn't it? Such a vibe, man.
So that was The Pharaoh. We really enjoyed watching this episode. Let us know down in the comments what episodes you want us to react to next. We have a very long list of requests and we are getting through them slowly and surely, so we will get to the episodes you request eventually. Let us know what your favourite episode from season one is, because we're really enjoying revisiting season one, and it's very nostalgic for us, and I'm sure it's very nostalgic for a lot of you guys as well.
Make sure, if you're not subscribed already, that you subscribe and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new videos.
That's it from us. We'll see you next time. Bye!
Bye!